वक्त तो हमेशा बदलता ही रहता है, चाहे वो घड़ी के सेकंड्स हो या कैलेंडर का लास्ट मंथ ऑफ द ईयर. Well, as we gear up for the new year of 2019, your favorite host Priya brings you yet another fun-packed episode of your favorite TV show Zee Connect. लोग कहते हैं कि बीते दिनों को याद करके कोई फायदा नहीं, लेकिन मैं कहती हूँ कि फायदा है, especially जब बात हो रही हो about the musical legend Panchamda, जिनकी याद में हुआ ये event.
Panchamda is one of the composers who is very close to our heart because when we look at the history of Indian or Hindi film music, the change happened during Panchamda's time. That is the time I feel that music became modern and blended with the world music. So that's the importance of Panchamda, because he was the person who really got us online with what was happening in the world around us.
सात साल से इस ग्रुप के साथ परफॉर्म कर रहे हैं और बहुत डिफ़िकल्ट है कि हमारा इसमें फेवरेट कौन सा सॉन्ग है, कौन सी कोरियोग्राफी है, क्योंकि सब सॉन्ग्स 101 है. आरडी बर्मन सबके फेवरेट कंपोजर है. सो इसमें बेसिकली ये सब 60s, 70s, 80s का एरा हमने दिखाया है. सो सब रेट्रो कोरियोग्राफी, टिपिकल जो बॉलीवुड बोलते हैं उसको वो नहीं है, रेट्रो एरा पूरा हमने इसमें पोर्ट्रे किया है. और उस ज़माने में ज़्यादा कोरियोग्राफी नहीं रहती थी, सो वो टास्क ज़्यादा डिफ़िकल्ट है, क्योंकि आजकल में एक्रोबैटिक हिप हॉप वेस्टर्न डांस फॉर्म्स ज़्यादा है. सो उस समय उतना कोरियोग्राफी नहीं था, लेकिन सब हीरोज़ का स्टाइल सबसे अलग था. सो हमने वो स्टाइल रख के और कोरियोग्राफी में थोड़ा सा रेट्रो फील दे के ये पूरा शो कोरियोग्राफ किया है.
We are the singers of today's evening. The evening is about Panchamda, R.D. Burman, the legendary composer of the golden era. And we are going to sing all the best celebrated songs of R.D. Burman.
The major task is to change the costumes, because each and every songs we try to match the costumes which were in the films also.
I and my husband Bharat have organized the show today, which is Pancham, the genius of R.D. Burman. This is a Diwali treat for our community members. We are expecting a full house of 1500 of our community members today, and we selected Niche Entertainment as last year also we had event organized which we had called in Niche Entertainment for 100 years of Bollywood. It was thoroughly enjoyed by our community members.
Moving on to a little serious topic now. The impact of humans on the environment and climate has been a talk globally, and environmentalists and wildlife activists have been doing their best to lessen the danger humans pose to the Earth's ecology. Zee Connect ki team ja pahunchi International Wildlife Festival par, jahan photography ke zariye wildlife preservation ki baat pahunchai ja rahi thi.
In a year's time, if 10 to 100 species is supposed to vanish from this earth, right now, just because of rainforest destruction, we are losing around 27,000 species from this planet Earth. So that is the reality. What we want to do is we want to spread this awareness among local people, across the world. So we feel when you have images as a medium, we will be able to convey this message in a very faster way.
Photographs actually is the easiest way of connecting people with the nature and the common mass. And if you have connection, then only you can think of something. So if I tell you that you, for conservation, you think on this species. If you don't know the species, so there will be no emotional connection. So the photo does that. So image always create a connection, and then it builds a emotional relationship with the viewer and the subject.
We believe that perhaps the main objective of all nature and wildlife photography is to shorten the distance between man and nature, to make people connect with what is important, and that is our planet.
And I mean, everyone starts small. Yeah. It's not that everyone is professional from the beginning. You start with a photo of a bird, you come to a polar bear maybe in the end.
Again, once we are back, there is going to be lots and lots of fun, so don't you go anywhere. Zee Connect par bane rehne ke liye aapka shukriya. Recently, the founder of Art of Living and spiritual guru Shri Shri Ravi Shankar was in the UAE to hold his very first yoga and meditation masterclass. Aur aapke liye hum lekar aaye hain iski ek jhalak.
नमस्कार, सलाम, प्रणाम, हेलो. मेरा नाम है गगन मुद्गल और आप देख रहे हैं जी कनेक्ट. आज मैं जिनके साथ बैठा हूं, उन्होंने अपने आप से कनेक्ट करने के लिए दुनिया को बहुत समझाया है. सांसें कैसी ली जाए ये भी बताया, इसलिए आज बहुत सालों के बाद सांस जो है वो ठीक से चल रही है. गुरुदेव, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, और जितना शुक्रिया कहा जाए उतना कम है. गुरुदेव श्री श्री रविशंकर जी हमारे साथ हैं. बहुत बहुत स्वागत इस शो में आपका. पहला सवाल मेरा आपसे ये है कि इस बिजी लाइफ में, जब सब लोग भाग रहे हैं, दौड़ रहे हैं, लोगों के पास सांस लेने का टाइम नहीं है, योगा को और मेडिटेशन को कैसे फिट किया जाए आज की इस दुनिया में?
देखिए, एक व्यक्ति जितने भी व्यस्त हो, सुबह उठ के दंत मंजन तो करते हैं. ये डेंटल हाइजीन है, फिजिकल हाइजीन है. ऐसे मेडिटेशन जो है मेंटल हाइजीन है. तुम्हारे मन को प्रसन्न रखना, उत्साहित रखना, कहीं जाओगे वहाँ शार्पनेस ऑफ अटेंशन, इन सब के लिए काम आए.
वो क्या चीज है जिससे ये जो हो रहा है दुनिया में, जो जो नेगेटिविटी है वो कम हो जाए? कहाँ पे, कौन से रास्ते पे चलने की जरूरत है इस वक्त?
अग्रेशन और डिप्रेशन के बीच में हम जूझ रहे हैं. या युवा बहुत अग्रेसिव हो रहे हैं, उद्दंडता कर रहे हैं, तोड़फोड़ कर रहे हैं, या ऐसे कमरे में बंद होकर के बैठ जाते हैं और आत्महत्या की तरफ निकल पड़ते हैं. इतना डिप्रेस हो जाते हैं, कुछ करते नहीं है, दिन भर सोते रहते, ऐसी हालत होती है. तो इन दोनों के बीच की जो स्वस्थ जीवन की रहस्य है, वो एक पाठ के रूप में इनको पढ़ाना पड़ेगा, ट्रेनिंग देनी पड़ेगी. देखिए, यहाँ देखिए कितना स्वच्छ रखते हैं. ये एक ऐसे आया ट्रेनिंग से, ये भी एक जो है प्रशिक्षण के माध्यम से हमें मिलना चाहिए.
क्या बात है. आखिरी सवाल जी कनेक्ट में आपसे ये है, जो यंगस्टर्स के लिए सोशल मीडिया का जो एक तूफान सा आया है, और जिससे कभी कभी रेस्टलेसनेस होती है, जब हमें फेसबुक पर पोस्ट करना है, इंस्टाग्राम पर स्टोरी में बताना है, और फिर देख के लगता है कि यार मेरी जिंदगी में कुछ नहीं हो रहा है, वो जो एक बेचैनी क्रिएट होती है, उससे कैसे कैसे लड़ा जाए?
नहीं, वो ठीक है, वो बेचैनी थोड़ी बहुत तो रहनी चाहिए यंगस्टर के जीवन में, थोड़ी बहुत बेचैनी ठीक है, मगर वो जा उसको अपने आप को कंज्यूम नहीं करने दो. बेचैनी इतना ना बढ़ जाए कि तुम्हें को मार दे, ये नहीं होनी चाहिए. थोड़ी बहुत बेचैनी से क्रिएटिविटी आएगी, कुछ सृजनात्मक कुछ करने का उमंग जागेगा, आशा जागेगी, ये तो होना चाहिए.
क्या बात है. गुरुदेव श्री श्री रविशंकर, हमें अपने से जोड़ने के लिए और हमें सब कुछ सिखाने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका.
Okay.
Now let's take you to some filmy entertainment. 11 Days is an Arabic and English movie dedicated to the year of Zaid and directed by Mr. Sudhir. Check this out.
We need three people for our audition. Three-year-old girl.
Action!
What's your name, beautiful girl?
Poha.
I want Po.
Your time starts now.
Sometimes we have short amount of time. If we take this place for 2-3 hours. 2-3 hours we have to finish. We cannot take our time and take it easy and just relax. So we have to come, shoot, and leave. But then we have problems, you know. Sometimes the aircraft will pass, sometimes something will happen. As he said, Ali, sometimes start raining and you're not ready for the rain. You cannot shoot.
You need to wait the next day.
Yeah. And no. He doesn't have time, and every day costing us money.
Everything is
all calculated.
The only thing we would like to say to him, thank him so much.
When all the directors are there saying that it's time to sleep because we're going to wake up early tomorrow, we have a scene, and we don't want to miss it because it was raining, and then you guys sleeping. And then as soon we reach to the room, I cannot sleep. And then, you know, like I feel I want to eat something and I'm hungry. I'm there, you feel hungry. I feel hungry every 2 hours because I'm training. I'm like a trainer. I train people in the gym. So I call Ahmed, I say, Ahmed, what do you have idea? Because I want to eat. So what I can do? He say, let's go to cut the fruits and then we'll eat and we'll have a nice conversation. I say, what about Sudhir? Sudhir is going to wake up us in the morning. I say, man, don't forget, we're going to sleep in the set. I say, no, you cannot. You cannot sleep in the set.
I wake up, I say, make up. My eyes are so red. I'm like, please put something more, you know.
Everyone know who is this guy. Why we call him our father, Year of Zaid. Because without him, even me and you will not be standing here like this. الحمد لله.
أول شيء تحرش بطفل قاصر. My son will never even think such crimes. ثاني شيء تعاطي مخدرات. هذه ما تسميها جريمة؟
مستحيل. مستحيل.
أنا مو براد البلاد إلا وأحمد ولدي وياي، سمعت؟
She's like my daughter. We're delegated by God to save her.
Zee Connect पर और भी बहुत सारी stories हैं, लेकिन you don't need to go anywhere for anything. आखिर हम हैं ना यहाँ. So stay tuned and we are going to be right back. Thank you so much for staying with us on Zee Connect. आज के Wellness with Zulekha में we are talking to Dr. Chandrabose from Zulekha Hospital, a consultant plastic surgeon who is going to be telling us all about liposuction.
Hi, this is MJ Pavitra Menon from Manu 6.2 Big FM on Wellness with Zulekha. Today we have with us Dr. Chandrabose, who is a consultant plastic surgeon right here with Zulekha. Welcome to our show, sir.
Thank you so much.
So speaking of liposuction, what exactly is liposuction?
Okay. Lipo means fat, suction means to remove.
Right.
So liposuction means basically you remove fat from the body. Right. Initially, when we started liposuction, we are using negative pressure or the negative suction force to remove the fat.
Okay,
that was called the suction assisted liposuction.
Right.
Then came the power assisted liposuction, where the mechanical probes that vibrate, and that vibration causes the fats to break down and that liquefied fat is sucked out.
Okay.
The next generation was using ultrasound. Now ultrasound was passed into the body, mm-hmm. and that broke down the fat and that was sucked out. Mm-hmm. The latest one is the laser assisted, mm-hmm. where laser is used to break down the fat and the fat is sucked out.
Right. So is there actually a good candidate for a liposuction? Do you think this is the right person?
Yes.
For it?
There is a set criteria. Mm-hmm. Basically what we say is that any person who is within 30% of the ideal body weight.
Mm-hmm.
Ideal body weight is calculated by using the body mass index.
Okay.
When one's height and weight is measured and it's calculated.
Correct.
Any adult mm-hmm. who is within the 30% of ideal body weight with a good skin tone, with a good muscle tone,
mm.
is an ideal candidate for liposuction.
Are there any side effects at all?
Yes. Like any surgical procedure has got minor and major complications. Okay. Liposuction also has minor and major complications. Okay. The minor complications being, we introduce small tubes into the body where we can suck out the fat. In order to introduce these small tubes, we make small cuts. So there is a chance for infection at that cut. So that's a minor complication.
Oh, okay.
And the major complications, severe complications can be like whenever you do liposuction, a small segment of blood supply gets cut off when you do procedure. Sometimes bleeding can happen. Mm-hmm. So you get bluish coloration of the skin, which will go back or become normal over a period of time, probably like 3 weeks time.
Right.
But if you do aggressive liposuction, mm-hmm. if you're not careful, mm-hmm. there can be permanent damage to the blood supply of the skin. That means the skin can become black in color,
okay.
and that becomes dead, and that has to be removed. That is one major complication. Sometimes severe infection sets in on the entire area where you had done the liposuction,
okay.
which can be at times fatal. Mm-hmm. That is another complication. Mm-hmm. And extremely, extremely rare complication where if you don't anticipate or if you don't identify the condition where it can result in the death of a patient mm-hmm. is what we call fat embolism. Mm-hmm. Fat embolism is a condition where the fat globules get sucked into one of the major vessels mm-hmm. and that goes into the heart and gets churned up and becomes frothy. What happens is the oxygen transfer doesn't happen. Basically, patient dies because of starvation of oxygen.
Okay.
So unless you diagnose this condition, is fatal, but it is extremely, extremely rare. Mm. Even though this is mentioned, very rarely does it happen.
Can you actually tell us what is that offers that Zulekha Hospital has to give to its patients about plastic surgeries?
Being a cosmetic surgeon as well as a reconstructive surgeon, I do both. In fact, in the cosmetic part, we do liposuction, as I mentioned earlier.
Right.
We do abdominoplasty, tummy tuck, and we are offering something called the mummy makeover. This is a package for patients who have completed the family.
Mm.
So women who have completed the family can come for like tightening their abdominal skin, lifting the breast if it's like loose and hanging, and like liposuction also if they put on excess fat. Okay. Where we do reconstruction for like post-cancer surgery, especially for women after mastectomy. And we do pediatric plastic surgery, where like children with congenital deformities, with deformities of the hand, ears, like cleft lip and cleft palate. And for trauma also. Trauma, like basically microvascular surgery, where the limb is cut, we put it back. Any major trauma where tissue needs to be reconstructed, we do that also.
Correct.
It's a complete package from Zulekha.
Thank you so much, doctor, for spending so long with us.
Thank you so much.
And you thought we forgot about Neeraj Sridhar? Aisa kaise ho sakta hai? Well, at the Bollywood Parks present the Big Zee Diwali Festival of Lights, we got a chance to have a quick chat with the popular singer Neeraj Sridhar. Let me show you. Neeraj sir, so good to have you here in Dubai with us, and we cannot wait to see you perform tonight. Neeraj sir, you were the pioneer of singing Hinglish songs. You brought that to Bollywood, which nobody would have ever thought at that time, and it has come to stay. How did you ever think of doing something like that?
It just happened by an accident. I went to a place where there were not too many Indians or Pakistanis, you know, like your own brothers, like you have here. So it was difficult. It was difficult to speak in your own language to another. There were no radio stations. There were nothing such as that. And once in a while when you went to London, you picked up some VHSs and watched some movies. In my case also, the same thing happened. So I picked up some VHS, and it was this movie called Aradhana. And I was traveling by a train, and I was the only one in the bogie, and I kept singing. Mere sapno ki rani kab aayegi tu. And I forgot the lyrics. So I just made up my own in English, and I laughed at my own self that time. But later on, my friends appreciated it, and I realized that I've got a gold mine in my hands.
You've sung so many, you've composed so many songs for Bollywood films and sung them, and each of those songs have been chartbusters. It's not like you know, some singers, they just have so many songs in their kitty, but yeah, not all of them are popular. But for you, you know, that's not the case.
I was considered by a lot of them, the guys who performed my favorite, Shankar Razana Loy. Loy is a good friend of mine, yes. Otherwise I've known him for many years. And so is Shankar. And they also used to say that I've got some kind of a magical touch. I sang, my very first song for them was Ticket to Hollywood. Which they might have performed yesterday, I don't know, but I love that song. And then Hey Baby, it carried on from there and never stopped. I love that song, Chandni Chowk to China.
Yeah.
So then it was Vishal Shekhar also, they gave me Honeymoon Travel, Halke Halke Rang Chalke, and Ajab Leher Hai, I don't remember the movie's name. But it just happened that me and Preetam, we clicked together. And Preetam couldn't work without me, I couldn't work without Preetam. So one after the other, it just happened to... The moment I sang Hare Krishna Hare Rama, I think I was there in Bollywood for good. And a lot of people ask me, why are you not doing it now? And you know, you've done so many big songs. Sometimes people think because the new singers have come,
So
there's no space for you, but it's not correct. Even the last song that I sang, the big one was Tumhi Ho Bandhu Sakha Tumhi with Preetam. It was not a failure, it was a huge hit. So,
as I said,
I'm not doing it because I want to do something of my own now. I'm tired of singing other people's songs. So I'm doing some films now as music director, and hopefully people will like me in that role as well.
They will. We've always loved you. We'll continue loving you, and we cannot wait to see you on the stage. But before you go, two lines of one of your favorite songs, as you mentioned, Ticket to Hollywood is what we want to listen to.
I don't remember the lyrics for that, actually.
I can show you. Do you want me to?
Okay,
or any song that you would like to sing for us? Akhiyon ke neele
अखियों के नीले शीश महल में सोनियों सोनिया बह जानी बह जा एक दिन जीना है तो रह जा तेरे बिना जीना भी है क्या टिकट टू हॉलीवुड अरे टिकट टू हॉलीवुड टिकट टू हॉलीवुड अरे टिकट टू हॉलीवुड समथिंग लाइक दैट आई हैव नॉट संग दिस फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम आई थिंक आई एम सिंगिंग दिस सॉन्ग आफ्टर 3-4 इयर्स या
Thank you so much. That was wonderful.
But what's going to happen tonight there, you'll enjoy it.
Connect पर अगले हफ्ते होगा एक और एक्साइटिंग एपिसोड विद मोर स्टोरीज मोर एंटरटेनमेंट तब तक के लिए विशिंग यू ऑल अ ग्रेट वीक अहेड फ्रॉम द एंटायर क्रू ऑफ जी कनेक्ट हियर एट द पेंटहाउस 5 पाम जुमेरा टेक केयर मूविंग ऑन टू अ लिटिल सीरियस टॉपिक डैमेज ह्यूमंस डेंजर फिल्मी एंटरटेनमेंट सो ग्रीन वाओ मेडिटेशन मास्टर क्लास बदलता ही रहता है कैलेंडर का लास्ट ईयर ऑफ द मंथ ओह गॉड